When the Jewish leaders saw the man carrying his mat, they said to him, "This is the Sabbath. No one is allowed to carry a mat on the Sabbath." But he replied, "The man who healed me told me to pick up my mat and walk." They asked him, "Who is this man that told you to pick up your mat and walk?" But he did not know who Jesus was, and Jesus had left because of the crowd. Later, Jesus met the man in the temple and told him, "You are now well, but don't sin anymore, or something worse might happen to you." The man left and told the leaders that Jesus was the one who had healed him. They started making a lot of trouble for Jesus because he did things like this on the Sabbath. But Jesus said, "My Father has never stopped working, and that is why I keep on working." Now the leaders wanted to kill Jesus for two reasons. First, he had broken the law of the Sabbath, but even worse, he had said that God was his Father, which made him equal with God. Jesus told the people, "I tell you for certain that the Son cannot do anything on his own. He can only do what he sees the Father doing, and he does exactly what he sees the Father do." Those words come from John 5, verses 10 to 19. If Jesus could only do the things he saw his Father doing, then we must see what God is doing before we will be able to do anything. So if you want to be like Jesus, you will search the Scriptures and watch the world around you to see what God is doing. Then, as a follower of Jesus, you will be able to do those things as well. Let your focus be on God and look for what He is doing in the world. Then you will know what you can expect to see Him do when you call upon His name and ask Him to exercise His power through your life. If Jesus was limited by being able to do only those things that he saw the Father doing, then we must ask God to show us what he is doing. Then you will begin to see the power of God working in your life. Lord Jesus, help me today to see what you are doing and give me the faith to pray for those things to continue. Praise your holy name, now and forever. Amen.